Are you rolling? Yeah. Okay. Should we do this properly?
Yes.
Okay. Backstage of the MOBO Tour. We're in London with Josh Osho.
I'm well, thank you, Carly. Yeah.
How's the MOBO Tour been?
The MOBO Tour has been amazing, actually. Didn't really know what to expect because I've never done a tour with so many other artists. And obviously, like, the dynamic of the other ones is completely different from what I'm doing. So I was a bit, like, unsure, but so far it's just been amazing. There's been really good reception from all the cities. And more people know who I am than I thought as well. So it's been a good eye-opener. But yeah, it's been awesome.
You're on a roster with some pretty cool people.
Yeah.
Like, who's the worst behaved?
Probably Rizzle Kicks.
Obviously.
Yeah.
They're hyper.
I play football with them as well in the week.
But just generally? Just,
yeah,
we're just going for a kick around. I'm going for a kick around with Rizzle Kicks.
Well, Smiler comes around. There's loads of different people that go. But we just play football on Tuesdays. They're both quite good, actually. But yeah, not probably. 100% definitely Rizzle Kicks. Climbing up the ladder. And she's sitting pretty high.
I got everything that matters. So what are you performing tonight?
Songs from my forthcoming album. Ebenezer Hotel, Redemption Days, SOS or Highlight, I haven't yet decided. And my next single, Giants, which is out in April.
When I've seen you perform, because the way that you conduct yourself on stage, you are quite chill, quite quiet, quite placid. Yeah. Like, when I first met you, I thought, hang on a minute, what's this all about? You should be more like Clement Marfo crowd
but
surfing.
You know what it is, yeah? It's because when I'm on stage, like, I'm in a different zone. Like, as much as I'm trying to connect with the people, I wrote the songs as much for myself as well. So I'm connecting with, every time I perform, I'm reconnecting with the songs.
Mm-hmm.
And you're just in, I can't really explain it unless like you perform it, you're just in a different place. So yeah, no, you just feel really inspired. So it kind of transforms a bit. And then when I get off stage, you kind of come off it a little bit. It's a bit like, yeah, it's like a drug. That is what it's like.
That was a proper light bulb moment then.
Not that I've taken drugs yet, but you know when you see like people that take
these
heroin?
These drugs.
Yeah, these are my drugs.
Yeah.
But say you take heroin, just for example.
Okay, yeah, every weekend.
Yeah, and you're a like, super, super like crazy guy. If you take it, then you just go really calm and because you're just in a different zone. And that's what it's like with music, it's like a drug.
Right. Life less scary, if ever I'm afraid. But no, I won't forget. When the rain kept coming, and the floods kept running. I was losing ground. Emeli Sande tour, talk to me.
I'm gonna be on it.
How exciting is that?
Very exciting, yeah. She's amazing. And I heard today her album went platinum, so yeah, deservedly, amazing album. I'm just excited as much to be supporting her, just to get on like stage again. But when you tour, you get this like bug, like a tour bug, performing back to back every night. Even though people might think it's monotonous, and I'm sure it gets to a stage when it is, but it's just like a new crowd, more people to connect with. It's just, it feels different every night when you step on stage. Dirty hand, roll with a punch or two. I love the song, different levels, my mind was split in two.
What if one of your fans came up to you today and said, Josh, you know what, I'm getting down on one knee, I want to marry you, what would you say?
It kind of happened already.
Has it?
Not in that way, but when I was in Glasgow, I was signing just bits and bobs and taking photos. And this girl came up to me and took her ring off and gave it to me. And she's like, I had to give you this ring, I had to, so you can remember me. And I took it and said thank you. So I guess if a fan proposed to me, I'd say thank you. What could I couldn't say yes. And then she takes it realistically and then like, I'll wreck her life by saying yeah, I'll marry you, and then don't. So,
oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh bless her. So she's thinking, I'm married to Josh and she's telling the world that she's your wife.
Her reality is that, so I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna say it's not. So if she's married to me, she's married to me.
Oh, you're just gonna get a lot of wives doing
this. I'm Nigerian, so my family will be
proud. That's alright. Well look, yeah. Josh, will you marry me?
Yeah, sure,
Carly. I have to fit on your finger.
Oh, okay. Wait, fit, I've got really big fingers.
Oh look. Yes, I've got two husbands. Well, Exploder said yes too. And he can get on his finger. Yeah. I've got two husbands so far.
Well, we're only half married because...
Ah! Josh Osho, my new husband. For Smashdown TV and iMusic. How to believe I achieved through divine intervention. I'm a soldier, I'll be standing on the day of redemption. If you know what you want, you're there.